So, changing the auxiliary belts on the car, jack up the car, axle stand, take the wheel off, the side liner off, okay. Wheel off. Now the liner. From what I can see, there should be just a few clips and I think those three screws here. Clips and these you can buy from eBay for like £6, 10, 20 pieces. I can't really remember. There we go. I think it was like £6. I'll try and put the link in description, or at least how they're called. Trim clips, something, whatever.
Right, so
there's one here on top, just one back here, there's one here, there should be one inside the wing, but it wasn't there when I put it back. And three screws that hold this piece here. Take them off. And in front underneath. Should be three. One, two, three. Something like that. I think there should be a screw there. I'll see. Should come off now. The belts. I have two of them, no AC, so they're like two short ones. I hope they're the right size, because one looks wider. This is an O3 Micra. So, okay, now load of crap, whatever, washing liquid tank. These are my belts. 1, 2. I hope it will focus. From Eurocar parts. I don't know if the codes mean something to you or not. Right, so just have to check are like the same or not. I'll bring my calipers out. Right. belts.
Alexa, put my Buster playlist.
Okay. They're the right size. It's this code here. As you can see, it is 4PK830. We got like 14 millimeters. So, try and replace the alternator belt. Looks like it's the first one. So, by the looks of it, alternator belt is the first one, and then the second one should be the water pump. Ooh, looks like there is some writing in there that I wasn't able to see from up. All right, so. Here's your pulley, here's your alternator pulley, hope you can see it, there it is, this is the one that stretches it, yeah, and so what you should do first is undo this nut, you undo this nut first, and then this nut. Okay, I'll give it a go, we'll see how it works. Little bit of WD-40. And in the back. One and then the other one. Oh, I don't know how to get that one, but still okay, so the pulley nut, it's a 14, it's pretty tight, so it's better to use a ring spanner and the open end, because I don't know, it's just better. And the stretcher, it's a 12 millimeter. the other way around. I just said you have to tie the release. It's looking on time. Okay. Off. That's it. That's the belt. Actually, so that's it. The pulley. That's good or not, I have no idea. Maybe I should take it off and clean it and put some grease on it, I don't know. I'll see. But the belt looks very good actually. There are no cracks. If you see some horizontal cracks like that, small ones, that's fine, but this one looks very very good actually. Maybe it was changed recently, I don't know. Anyway, I'll replace it, fuck it. The new one, it's not much of a difference between them. I replaced anyway, I think they are the same length. Let's see. Same length. Okay, I'm gonna take this this pulley out. See what's what. Maybe I can clean it a little bit. Pull these out. Oh, there's a bearing. I looked, it's looks in good condition. And the way you like check it if it's okay. There's some grease out, but. Like you move it here, right? You move the inside. If nothing happens, you move it this way. And if you don't feel any play, that's okay then. I could probably. Probably take this plastic seal off and pack it with some more grease, but if it works okay, you shouldn't do that. Sometimes if you tie too much the belt, it will damage this one and all the other pulleys, all the other bearings around the. So be careful when you tie it. The limits. Okay, put it back then. And we'll move next. We'll move to the next one. Okay. Right. I'll put some grease on that pin. How the hell can I position this camera? Okay, I'll hold it. Try to do it with one hand. Now you're thinking maybe it's too much, but remember, anything greased won't corrode. If you put grease on something, won't corrode. Everything's gonna be fine. Don't put grease on your brake drums or brake discs. But other than that, anything you put grease on will last for longer. Right, so, same. On this side, 14 millimeters. Alright, can you see that? Yeah, so 14 millimeters and 12. But this one will undo normal way. So lefty loosey, righty tighty. So this is lefty loosey. And it will loop. Okay, now this one, 14. I'm gonna try and undo it. Adjustment board, adjustment board and pulley nut. Adjustment board, those are called adjustment bolts. Right. I don't know how to put my 14 mil in there, but I'll see. Not high enough, for sake. Okay. Right. Found a way. Hold the camera in place, hopefully. It's gonna be okay. Okay. Let me see how I can undo that one. Yeah, gave up eventually. Now I think you'll have to take this one off so we can remove the belt. I don't know if there's enough slack or hey, it's off. Okay. Let's take it off. The water pump as well. Yeah. Definitely looks worse. Right, so. Show now. So there we go. There's your pulley. come on. Let's get all right. And the adjustment bolt. Okay. Okay. Right. And okay. The water pump. It's here. This is the water pump. Water pump. Ooh, ooh, yeah. If we're here and we have the belt off, we should check the water pump bearing. Okay. Yeah, so you do the same thing. Like with the pulley, you just grab the water pump. Just grab the water pump and just wiggle it. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. So, nope. It looks like it's good. Turns well. Yeah, should be alright. Okay. Okay, I'll show you now how a bad belt looks like. See those small cracks? You don't have to worry a lot about them, okay? Because they should be normal. But looks bad on the outside as well, you see. Snackered. So this is the new one. What the Let me see the code. Yeah, look, there's a code here as well. 3PK670. Let me see if I can see. This one, there's a different code. It says, this one says 11720BX010. So don't really know what I make of that. But they're the same size. That's what's important. They're the same size. Hopefully. New one looks a little bit longer. Oh shit. But the pulley will pull it. That's its job. Its job. So, okay. Now, next. It's the new ones. The big one, alternator, water pump. Okay. Oh, I'm gonna take this pulley out as well. I just want to see if the bearing is okay and all that stuff. So you just undo this knot. Okay. Alright. Knot off. Then the pulley should come off. Like that. Oof. Perfect. Oh, so I don't know if you saw on the other one, but when you put them back, it's always this big side is on the inside. Okay, the one that comes a lot more out should be inside towards the engine. So the other one the same. Okay, just clean it, put some grease on it and put them back off. Let me see if they, yeah,
feels fine. Okay.
I'm changing my oil filter as well, because last time when I changed the oil, they picked the wrong part for me. So I'm just gonna change the filter and that's it. Not the oil, not nothing. I'll just take it out, make a little mess, put a new one in. That should be it. This is the type W610/4. I've ordered it and they delivered something else, so
I didn't check. I came home, I've changed the oil, took the oil out, and when I want to put new filter, it was a paper filter in. So now, most important thing when you change the oil is to put some oil inside the filter. I had this filled till the top just a minute ago, and it now there's nothing in there. It all got sucked up. So should put some more. That's it. Because the filter is made like of a special paper inside, and it will absorb some oil. A lot of it actually, maybe like 100 mils, maybe more. Now, to take the old one out, just use one of these adjustable oil filter key. This is a good one. There is another one with like a screw. I don't feel that's enough flexibility it has for me, so just put it around the filter here where you see those grooves in the back, and then you tie it right. You tie it here, you put the chain through those pins, that's it, and just turn it on. You just undo it with this key. You never tie it with this key, never ever. The filter should always be tied by hand. Boom, that's it. Okay. Alright, I'll make a mess now. Okay, and before you put the filter in, the oil filter, always you wet. You wet this side with oil, yeah? Yeah, you put some oil around. That will create a seal around. Okay, that's it. I'm gonna take the other one out. It's gonna have to be quick, so I can't. I don't know how to film this. I'm going to put the camera, because the camera will get in my way if I leave it somewhere here. Maybe here? Let me move this one. Is it? Can you see something? I have no idea. Anyway, I'll take it out. Put the new one in. quicker you are, less mess you're gonna make. But I put some cardboard underneath, so yeah, that's the old one out, and now the new one in. Just remember, just tie it by hand. That's it. Should be enough. Out. Right. Now, putting the belts back, go like this. You put the first one, yeah, in the back. In the back, around the water pump and then the pulley. But if you don't know how to put them back, if you're a knob and you forgot, there it is. Oh, take it down. There it is. So, this is mine. I have no air conditioning, no compressor, nothing. So mine is like this. It goes round the adjuster, intermediate pulley, round the water pump on top, and underneath the crankshaft. Yeah? And then the alternator one goes round the crankshaft pulley, round the alternator, and behind the intermediate pulley. Yeah, so this is around and this is behind it. Okay, right, I'll show you the tolerances as well. Right, auxiliary drive belt, it's with air conditioning 7 to 8 millimeters and limit 14 millimeters, and without air conditioning, the one that I have, the alternator belt is 10 to 11 millimeters and the water pump is 7 to 9, so 7 to 9 for me and 10 11. What that means is when you tie it down, you shouldn't have a movement like this more than 10 to 11 millimeters. It's pretty easy to see, set those tolerances, but I'll show you how in a moment. Right, so I'm gonna put this like they said around up here. That's around, yeah, that's, there it is on its place, hopefully. Should be around this crankshaft pulley, yeah, and the other one, yeah, and the water pump, yeah, that's it, that should be it. Yeah, this is it. Okay,
just tie this now. It doesn't work by hand. I'm gonna take the key and tie it a little bit, not too much. Don't tie it all the way. Not yet. Let me see if I can put the camera. If you can see something, I hope you can see. Right. Backward. Fuck's sake. And do it by hand. Like a million times. And now that is on. Should be okay. Now it's tight. Make sure it's around the water pump up there. Yeah. You see this? This is the play. They're talking about this here, right here. That's a lot of play for now, but we'll sort that out in a moment. Now, don't tie in anything else, just put the other one on, right? The big one around the alternator. Okay, let's see up there. So you see the belt has to come around here and around the alternator. I can't do it from here. I'm gonna have to do it from underneath. Oh yeah. I'm gonna put it around the alternator belt first. Alternator and then here. Yeah. I'm gonna try to slide it around the pulley. Hey! That's it.
Ooh, that's tight now. Yeah. Right, yeah. Okay, now what it says in the book is that you should turn the crankshaft a few turns. So you make sure that all your belts are, they sit properly, okay? So I don't know what the hell, what number is that? 24, 27?
24. Nah, that's 27, 30.
That's it, 30. Yeah, that's it, 30. Okay. By the way, you have to turn the engine clockwise, not anti-clockwise. So always clockwise, okay? Yeah. They seem to be okay. Right now, if you're happy, I am. If you're happy with how they sit and how they turn, that means they sit on their place. Ahead and tie them up. So which one first? Let's do the water pump first. No, I tied that pretty much. Now, I'm gonna show you, just have to bring a line. So, what you do, bring a line like this one. Woo! Right, this one, yeah. Normal line. Just put here, the longest part of traveling is. For me it's 11.9 centimeters. And this is the water pump, so that's 79 millimeters play. So I have 11.9. If I use my finger and pull it down. Sorry if you can't see this, but this is how we do it. And just to pull down, that's 4 millimeters. It will travel 6.
7. Let's say it's good. Let's say I think I have the right amount. Should be right. 12.9. Oh, sorry, 11.9. I'm going to 11.3 if I want. So that's 6 millimeters. Let's say 6, 7. Okay. It's going to stretch though. Later on, you have to do it again, like a month later, after a month or something. Okay? You have to do it again. Fucking corrosion. Right. Okay. Now, I'm gonna have to tie it down. I have to tie the pulley nut. Okay, that should be enough, God's sakes. Okay, right, next is this one. This one's gonna be a pain. Right, this one is untying. We'll do it. We'll tie it up. So. Okay. I'll check it. Seems a little bit loose. I'll do it a few more turns. Loose. Okay. See now. Still? For fuck's sake, let me tie this one down. Not a lot, but just a little bit. Now, checking the play on this one is gonna be hard, because you have to check the play on the longest run. So that's top side here. Right, I'll check it and then I'll come back to you. Okay, so what I found out, I can't do it with that measuring line, because it doesn't work. But try with a caliper. So what you do with a caliper is this one. You take the depth gauge out in the back. Oh, fuck's sake. Yeah? You take it out like that. You place it onto the belt up there. Like that. I think it's inside. Yeah, I like that. Something like that. Yeah. And you hold it against this wheel here. Right? You zero it. If you... Yeah? Then just compress the belt up there. That's 5.51. Okay. I'll do it again on this side. I'll hold it here. Zero. I'll compress it here now. 7.8. Like 8 millimeters, is that? No. It says 10 to 11 millimeters, so I'm gonna undo it a little bit more. And do it again. Right, so press it again. 9.5. Okay, I was 9.5. Let again. You have to hold it here. Right then, and now press it. Ah, oh, for fuck's sake. Right, I can feel it. It should be enough. So, okay, if you're happy with that, then you just try it out. That should be it. That should be it. I just have to turn the engine on and see if we get any noise and shit like that. The belts turn properly. Wheels are turning. Right, so the belts. Yeah, look around. Okay. I will check with the alternator. Water pump. And the pulley. Everything looks fine. Right. So let's check the voltage, the alternator. Volts. That's okay. Now we turn the lights on. Drop a little bit, because it has a oh, 14.1. Yeah, should be right. Should be all right. You hear no noise, no like squeaking or stuff like that. It should be okay. It should be okay. Yeah. Right, so that's about it, guys. For changing the belts. Oh, 9 here. That's about it for changing the belts. Oh, tensioning, it's right here, but it's, I don't know. It is important, of course, but you feel it by hand. If you can hear some squealing or shit like that, like that means it's loose. So you're gonna have to tie it again. Maybe in a month or something. What does it say here? By attaching blah 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 blah. So, belt adjustment assess blah blah blah. Okay,
If a new belt has been fitted, do not over-tension it to allow for the belt stretching instead. Recheck the tension after, say, a month or 1000 miles. It is quite normal for a new belt to require retensioning after its initial running in period. That's it. Okay. So, that's it. Have a lovely day. Okay, put all the shit back together. Put your wheel back. Take it for a spin or whatever. I'm a little bit concerned about these Nissan Micras. They don't have like underneath protection tray, you know, for the engine, like a plastic one to cover it. Anyway, I did change the oil. Gearbox oil yesterday, so if you want to do that, it's pretty simple. You need a square head, 8 millimeters, 8 millimeters square head for the nut. Yeah. Oof. 8 millimeter square head, and the gearbox oil is here. This is the gearbox oil nut. Here. Then, when you fill it up, you're gonna fill it up through here. It's a plastic one. Be careful when you undo this one. Plastic one, yeah? So you fill it up through here. It has to be level to fill it up. Okay? 2.6 liters you'll get into this one. 2.6 liters. 5-speed manual, 1.2 liters. So gearbox oil out, gearbox oil in. Okay? And engine oil out, it's here. This is a 14 millimeters normal. 40 millimeter. That's about 3 liters, 3.2 liters with a filter for the engine oil. Right. So, have a lovely day.